I welcome students to please not be intimidated by the language barrier, but rather see it as an opportunity to make an international friend and exchange ideas in a different sort of environment. So I welcome the students to WASDA.
The number of international students they have and the fact that they're offering various programs in English.
The dictatorship, but also rather than having real. I think my question was like.
Try to challenge yourself as much as possible. I think university is the place, especially the first 2 years, 2-3 years, that's when you can really challenge yourself to do a lot of things. It's okay to make mistakes.
Well, one of the challenges of teaching in an international environment is everyone comes from a different kind of educational system and an educational background. In teaching in an environment where English isn't everybody's native language, I try my best to focus on the content and not on the perfect English essay. But as long as they can express themselves in English, it doesn't matter if it's perfect. There's a lot we can learn from books and there's a lot we can learn from online. But there's nothing that can't replace the value of being in a classroom, exchanging ideas with other people. And that exchange of ideas, especially when you're in the classroom with people from different countries and different backgrounds, you can't get that online. You can't get that in a book. That's sort of an intangible, valuable part of university education. I think I understand why students enjoy discussion, because it helps them process these ideas and apply them to cases that they're interested in and chat with their classmates. So I also see a lot of value in them.
I hate to interrupt, but let's pull back and share some of your ideas. And I want to hear from you first.
世界観が広がったなという印象はあります。今まで高校自体、実は私男子校だった。男子だけの空間ということで、極めてみんなが考えていることが同じだったからこそ、居心地がいいというふうにも考えられるんですけど、むしろ早稲田に来て、いろんな背景を持つ、それこそ日本で生まれ育っていない人も含めて、さまざまな人が意見をそれぞれ持って、でそれぞれこうその意見をぶつかり合わせるというか、交流させることによって、また自分の価値観なり、そういうものが広がっていくのかなという感じはします。
Sometimes maybe the opportunity to express yourself in English, you're not confined to your own traditional, sort of accepted norms of behavior. So maybe you feel more comfortable expressing yourself in English and behaving in a way that might be different than you do in your Japanese persona. I don't know, I think the bilingual students should answer that question.
We call it Jinglish sometimes, but yeah, we mix like Japanese and English pretty often, I'd say.
I grew up speaking Japanese, but over time studying in Singapore, my English got better, and my level of English is enough to accommodate academic studies, while my Japanese isn't, even though I am perfectly comfortable conversing in Japanese. So I really like the fact that I can use both languages that I'm good at.
Japanese is also my first language, technically. It was the language I learned first. But now I think, honestly, English, because you just use it more often in day-to-day life.
It was a more fair election.
Democracy and like dictatorship, but then there are a lot of
the system, but at the same time, they know that they're civilians. I mean, they themselves are invested.
Yeah, exactly. Because they hold elections.
日本語で理解することが極めて大切だと思うんですね。やはり母語の、思考力というか、それを鍛えない限りには次に進めないとは思うんですね。でもその一方で、やはり英語を使うことで、むしろそのより多くの情報に触れて、でまたより多くの人に発信できる。
Waseda, for English speakers, like they just allow a completely English application process, so that was nice. I was pleasantly surprised that there was actually plenty of English courses available, not only from the school that I enrolled in, but you're actually able to take courses from other departments in Waseda that are also taught in English, and sometimes the contents are exactly the same as the Japanese courses. I was very happy about that, so I can practice my Japanese with Japanese courses when I want to, but like for my core courses, I can take them all in English and get plenty of credits to graduate.